Student, this is Bharti madam. Now I'm going to tell you about the admission of a partner, and we are going to discuss about the sacrificing ratio. Students, this problem will come for 6 marks in the annual exam, provided 12 marks question is from the retirement of a problem. If 12 marks is from the admission of a partner, then there will be no question on 6 marks from this topic. So sacrificing ratio will come for 6 marks, provided 12 marks is from the retirement of a partner. Now first of all, I will tell you what is sacrifice ratio. You know that admission is nothing but the incoming of a new partner. When the new partner is coming in, he will have to bring something in the form of the goodwill. He will have to bring the cash in the form of goodwill. And that whatever goodwill he is bringing in the form of cash should be distributed among the old partners. So how that goodwill or the cash, what he is bringing in the form of goodwill, how it should be distributed? And it should be distributed in the sacrifice ratio. So sacrifice ratio is nothing but what the old partners are sacrificing or they are giving to the new partner on the admission. So sacrifice ratio is nothing but it is a ratio in which the old partners agree to sacrifice their share of profit to the incoming partner, and it is in case of admission of a partner. Sacrificed portion or share equals to old ratio minus the new ratio or the new share. This sacrifice ratio is calculated to distribute the goodwill amount bought in cash by the new partners among the old partners. So students, there are many types of calculating the sacrificing ratio. But for your exams, remember that you will get is only wherein the new ratio is given as well as the old ratio is given to you. So when new ratio and old ratios are given, remember that you will have to go in for finding out the sacrifice ratio by deducting the old share minus the new share. Okay, now we will come to the problem. First problem, they have told you Rohit and Mohit are the partners in a firm. They are the old partners, okay? Sharing the profits in the ratio of 5:3. They admit Bijoy as a new partner for 1/7 share of profit. The new profit sharing ratio is 4:2:1. Calculate the sacrificing ratio among Rohit and Mohit. So remember students, you are only concerned with the old ratio and the new ratio. You have nothing to do with how much you are giving to the new partner. Okay. So first write sacrificed share equals to old share minus the new share, or old share of profit minus the new share of profit. Now in the problem they have given you, write one side, write to the left hand side Rohit, Mohit. Below that you write 5:3. So 5:3 will be 5/8 and 3/8. Next, come to your right hand side, write new ratio 4:2:1. That is nothing but 4+2+1. That will be 7. That is 4/7, 2/7 and 1/7. Next line. Rohit's share of sacrifice equals to, his old share is 5/8. And his new share is 4/7. So 5/8 minus 4/7. Students, those who are unable to know about the LCM, directly multiply 8 into 7. You get is 56. Now, take it to the opposite side. 5 into 7 and 8 into 4. 5 into 7 will be 35. 4 into 8 will be 32. So 35 minus 32 will be 3 by 56. Come to the next. Mohit share of sacrifice equals to his old share is 3 by 8 minus his new share is 2 by 7. So first 8 into 7 will be 56. Now 3 into 7 will be 21 minus 2 into 8 will be 16. 21 minus 16 will be 5 by 56. Now the sacrifice ratio of Mohit, Rohit and Mohit is 3 by 56 is to 5 by 56. That is nothing but 3 is to 5. Come to the next problem. Dinesh and Mahesh are the partners. They are the old partners sharing the profits in the ratio of 3 is to 2. They admit Ramesh as a new partner and the new profit sharing ratio among them is 5 is to 4 is to 3. Calculate the sacrifice ratio. Now come to the solution or the answer. Share sacrificed equals to old share minus the new share. Now come to your left hand side, write Dinesh, Mahesh. Below that you write 3 is to 2. So that will be 3 by 5 and 2 by 5. That 5 is nothing but 3 plus 2. Come to your right hand side, write Dinesh, Mahesh, Ramesh. Below that you write 5 is to 4 is to 3. That will be 5 by 12, 4 by 12 and 3 by 12. Next, Dinesh sacrificed portion equals to old share is 3 by 5 minus the new one is, new share is 5 by 12. Next, first multiply 5 into 12, that will be 60. Now come to the next. 3 into 12, that is 36. Next, 5 into 5, that will be 25. 36 minus 25, you will get is 11 by 60. Next, Mahesh sacrificed portion equals to his old share is 2 by 5 and his new share is 4 by 12. 5 into 12 will be 60. Next, 2 into 12, that is 24. 4 into 5, that is 20. 24 minus 20, that will be 4. And 60 as it is. Now, the sacrificed ratio of Dinesh and Mahesh is 11 by 60 is to 4 by 60. That is nothing but 11 is to 4. Come to the next problem. Bharti and Aarti are the partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3 is to 2. So this is the old ratio. They admit Manjula into the partnership. Full stop. They share the profits, that is a new profit sharing ratio is 4 is to 3 is to 3. Calculate the sacrificed ratio of Bharti and Aarti. Now come to the calculations. First, always you should write share sacrificed equals to old share minus the new share. Come to the next. Come to the left hand side, write Bharti Aarti. Below that you write 3 is to 2. That is 3 by 5 and 2 by 5. Come to your right hand side, write 4 is to 3 is to 3. That is nothing but 4 by 10, 3 by 10, 3 by 10. Now come to the next. Bharti's share of sacrifice equals to the old ratio is 3 by 5 minus the new share is 4 by 10. First, multiply 5 into 10, that will be 50. Next, come to the next. 3 into 10 will be 30. 4 into 5 will be 20. So 30 minus 20 will be 10 by 50. Or those who know the LCM, you can take the LCM as 10. And 3 into 2 is 6. 4 into 1 is 4. 6 minus 4 is 2. Come to the RT share. LCM between 5 and 10 is 10. So 5 is multiplied twice to get 10. So 2 also should be multiplied 2 times. 2 into 2 will be 4. 10 is multiplied only once. So 3 should be multiplied only once. 4 minus 3 will be 1 by 10. Next, the sacrificed ratio of Bharti and Aarti is 2 by 10 and 1 by 10, or it is 2 is to 1. Come to the next problem. Ravi and Kiran are the partners sharing the profits in the ratio of 5 is to 3. They admit Uday into partnership. The new profit sharing ratio is equally among the partners. Calculate the sacrificed ratio of Ravi and Kiran. First write, sacrificed share equals to old share minus the new share. Come to the next. Come to your left hand side, write Ravi and Kiran. Below that you write 5 is to 3. That is nothing but 5 by 8, 3 by 8. Come to the right hand side. Write Ravi, Kiran and Uday. They are already given to you in the problem. It is equally 1 is to 1 is to 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1, that will be 3. That is nothing but 1 by 3, 1 by 3 and 1 by 3. Come to the next. Ravi's share of sacrifice, that is the old share, is 5 by 8. And the new share is 1 by 3. So 5 by 8 minus 1 by 3. We will multiply now. 3 into 8 will be 24. Next. 5 into 3 will be 15. Minus 8 into 1 will be 8. That is 7 by 24. Come to the next. Kiran's share. His old ratio is 3 by 8. And new share is 1 by 3. So 3 by 8 minus 1 by 3. 3 into 8 will be 24. Next. 3 into 3 will be 9. Minus 8 into 1 will be 8. That is 9 minus 8 will be 1 by 24. Next. Sacrificed ratio between Ravi and Kiran is 7 by 24 is to 1 by 24. That is nothing but 7 is to 1. So that's all the students about the sacrifice ratio. And if you have any problems or any difficulties, you can put a comment or directly you can call to me. I will inform it. Okay. Next, in the last my video, they had asked me the question, why in the current account or in the P&L appropriation account, we do not record drawings. Remember students, I had told you, profit and loss appropriation account is a account wherein only the profit or the loss which is to be distributed among the partners is to be recorded in the appropriation account. So drawings is neither an income nor an expenditure for you. So it is the amount what you are withdrawing from the business for your personal use. It is nothing but the reduction in the capital. And as it is not a profit or a loss for you or among the partners, it is not recorded in the appropriation account. So when it is not recorded in the appropriation account, it will not be recorded in the current account. Students, one more. In the problem, if they say that they are maintaining the fixed capital method and if the appropriation account is asked for you, at that time, whatever is the profit, you should write it as to partner's current account and you should distribute it, okay? If they did not mention anything or if they have mentioned you as the capitals are fluctuating, then you should write it as capital account and distribute the profit. And remember, students, most of the times the problem will be on the fluctuating capital method. Only if they are specifically mentioned to you as the capitals are fixed, then only take it to the current account. Otherwise, always take it to the capital account only. So students, if you have any other difficulties, you can call me or you can put a comment on that and I'll be answering to you. Okay, thank you.